Welcome to Safety Church of Our Lady of the Lakes Parish. Please remember that masks are required and to be worn over the nose for the entire time you are in the church. It is recommended that you use hand sanitizer and receive communion in hand. Please stay safe during this pandemic and keep social distance between you and others. Thank you for your cooperation. You may drop your offering into the blue box located at the front of the church. Thank you. So that we can more prayerfully enter into our worship, we invite everyone to pray together the Holy Spirit prayer. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle them by the fire of your love. Send your Holy Spirit, and they shall be created, and you shall show you the face of the earth. O God, by the light of the Holy Spirit, did instruct the hearts of the faithful. Grant that by the same Holy Spirit, we may be truly wise and ever enjoy this consolation. Through Christ our Lord.
Hear me. Almighty, ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty and sincerity of heart. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, there is no other. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Before our God and Father. knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
They have malice.
they're malicious. And Jesus himself reprimands them. He says, why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Now the word hypocrite says it all. A hypocrite was the name of an actor on the Greek stage at the time of Jesus. The hypocrite would simply wear a face mask to play the role on stage. That's where that word comes from. Jesus is saying that they are false, that they are wearing a mask in front of them. But behind their mask, they are entirely different. It sounds like some of our politicians in the world today. Now, Jesus replied to the question about paying the tax to Caesar was masterful. The coin had an image of Caesar stamped upon it. So Jesus declares, to give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. This reply from Jesus has been used all throughout the centuries to teach us to act as good citizens in our own countries. Obviously, we do this by paying our taxes, defending our country, voting, and in many other ways. At the same time, our country is to serve its loyal citizens by taking what belongs to Caesar and leaving to God what belongs to God. God alone gives life, and only God can take away that life. It is not up to a country to decide that its unborn, whose lives come from God, can be killed while in the womb of the mother. Marriage is from God. The state definitely did not create marriage. Our civil government did not create marriage. Not even the church created the sacrament of marriage. God alone is the author of marriage between one man and one woman. God is the author. Any discussion about marriage these days always talks about rights. It wouldn't surprise me in another 5 or 10 years that if someone decides that they want to marry a horse, their own courts will go along with that. But any discussion that we talk about marriage that does not give God what belongs to God is not a complete discussion. Give to Caesar what is Caesar's, but give to God what belongs to God. How can a country which claims to be a Christian country, founded on Christian principles, ignore what belongs to God when making important decisions? Makes no sense. It's hypocritical. Do we want to be like those in the gospel tonight who came to Jesus and said nice things about him, but at the same time wore a mask over their face to cover the real self? Now the coin that was given to Jesus had an image of Caesar on it. And Jesus said, give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. But we also have an image, each and every human being on this earth. And it's the image of God on our soul. We read in Genesis that we are made in the image and likeness of God. If the coin belongs to Caesar, it is to be given to Caesar because it has Caesar's image on it. We belong to God and are to give to God because we have God's image on us. Giving to God comes naturally when we realize how much God loves us. The closer we come to God, the more we become friends with God, the more we want to give to God who gave us everything in the first place. Giving to God is not a choice, but pure joy for us in the act of love, because we are giving back to God who first loved us. He gave everything that we have to us, especially the gift of life. We give to God in so many different ways. We give to God by keeping Sunday, the Lord's Day, by coming to Mass, by worshiping Him together in community, by receiving His very body, blood, soul, and divinity and the Holy Eucharist each and every Sunday. God comes first. Those who do not go to Mass do not have the Eucharist at home. Life goes much better when God, with God, than without Him. God made us for Himself, and giving to God and putting God first in is the only way to find true happiness in our life. You know, our hearts long to love. We long to give love and to receive love, but ultimately to love God. That's how God made us. And we'll never be satisfied unless we have that relationship with God. And we also give back to God by spending time with Him in prayer each and every day. Prayer every day is an essential part of a Christian's life. Our world is becoming so secularized that we need to have God first if we're ever going to make it. Prayer every day keeps us close to Jesus and helps us to carry our own crosses in our life. Prayer every day is one of the ingredients to ensure that we are growing in holiness. You know, there's a new movie out called Prayer. It's about the life of Father Patrick Hayton. Maybe some of you know who he is. He was an Irish immigrant. He joined the Holy Cross Fathers and became a priest here in the United States. But before he became a priest, he was struck with a terminal illness. He was going to die. And he asked her Blessed Mother to intercede for him. And he made a promise to her that if she would intercede for him and he was to be healed, he would become a priest. And he would promote praying the rosary until the last day of his life. Father Patrick Hayton was healed miraculously through the intercession of the Blessed Mother. And he took that rosary as a spiritual weapon and stepped out into our secularized society. And he reminded people that the family that prays together stays together. He reminded all of us how important it is for us to pray. Brothers and sisters, if we're not praying, how can we ever have a real relationship with God? And true prayer that comes from the heart is a conversation with God. We all need to pray. And the highest form of prayer that there will ever be is the holy sacrifice of the Mass, what we are all participating in tonight. Because God will be present among us. And when we receive Him in the Holy Eucharist. Now the drama of the Gospel is being played out all around us today. We give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God. But there are some in our society that want to drown out the voice of Jesus. They want to take God out of our schools. They want to take God out of our politics. We cannot let that happen. There will always be those who oppose giving to God what belongs to God. We have God's image on us, imprinted on our souls. We belong to God. And the only way to true happiness is to put God first in our lives, in every aspect of our life, including in the next few weeks when we vote. We cannot leave our Christian faith outside of the voting booth. Jesus must be with us. And we must ask for the gift of the Holy Spirit to have a well-formed conscience to vote the way God wants us to vote. Is God interested in politics? Of course He is. Of course He's interested in every aspect of our lives on this earth. And especially if our politicians are not respecting life from the moment of conception until natural death. I don't know how any of these politicians who vote for killing life, what they expect when they leave this world. How will they ever explain that to God? We need to pray. We need to pray incessantly for the gift of the Holy Spirit for our country, for our politicians. Most especially, we need to pray to have a deep, intimate relationship with God. To understand that our lives are so, so very short on this earth. It will be over in an instant. And when we leave this world, we will be judged according to how we lived our lives as a Christian. My brothers and sisters, let us give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar. But let us give to God what belongs to God. Amen.
Father, we give you thanks and praise for listening to all our prayer petitions, but most especially.
lift up all of these intentions to you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated. similar way when the supper was over. Took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you and your Son, Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say a word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. benefiting from participation in heavenly things, may we be helped by what you give in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And I'm not sure what announcements we have, but just to keep in mind that we are beginning our RCIA classes. If there's anybody that you know of that is thinking about or contemplating about coming into the Catholic Church, please call one of our secretaries, either at St. Pete or St. Peter. We'd love to have them come and be part of it. Everything's social distance, it's online, they don't have to come in person. But maybe if they want to just inquire to see what the church is about. So ask your family and friends if there's anybody that you know that would be interested in learning more about the Catholic faith. We'd love to have them join our group. And finally, I mentioned in my homily that there's a movie out called Prayer. It's about the life of Father Patrick Hayden. And that movie is going to be shown in Gurney Mills Theaters this Thursday for one night. I encourage you, if you're out and about, to definitely go see this movie. I've already seen it. The priest had a sneak preview, and it was phenomenal. I can tell you so many stories, but I know you want to get home for dinner. So please bow your heads and ask for God's blessing. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and praise for the many blessings you bestow upon each and every one of us at this Mass, most especially the gift of your very Son and the Holy Eucharist. Lord, I ask that you look kindly upon all of your families present now, and bless them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in.